So basically, in a nutshell, I just wanted to be a reminder to myself first and foremost, and many of you Muslim brothers and sisters here today, by show of hands, you know how many born and raised Muslims? MashaAllah. I came from a Christian household. You know, I was young, very inquisitive. I used to spend 6 days a week in the church. So when I hear people say, you know, they're like diehard Christian, I'm like, okay, cool. I spent 6 days, man. I was a Cub Scout. So I played the piano. I was an usher. I was a Bible study. My grandmother was in a choir. I lived in the church. So I came to the conclusion that if I'm going to be here, I might as well take it serious. So I started taking Bible studies very serious. And as a young kid, I started reading things that were, you know, very contradicting. I was like, okay, what's going on here? You're telling me that Jesus is God. But why is he praying? Because, you know, coming from the streets, instinctively, you want to be with the powers that be. You want to be with the man. So if he's praying to somebody, I want to be down with that person he's praying to. I don't want to be down with him. He got somebody he calling when he in trouble, and that's who I want to get down with. I don't want to be down with him. You know, because that's instinctive for a person like myself. Coming from the streets, you want to get down with the boss. You know, I don't do the help. You know, I don't want to meet the secretary. I want to meet the boss. And it was just a lot of things I started to read. I'm just a young kid, you know, don't get me wrong. No, I'm not trying to offend anybody. I'm just saying this was my state of ignorance. And I remember questioning. I remember going to my pastor and I asked him a simple question. I said, well, you know, Jesus is God. Like, you know, why is he praying? And who is he praying to? And I never got an answer. You know, he kind of beat me up. And boy, you don't believe in Jesus, you're the Lord. I was like, oh, calm down. I didn't say that. You know, I'm just a kid. Like, relax. You know, I didn't say that. I just asked you if he's God, then who is he praying to? Just make it clear to me. I mean, I deserve that. I'm here 6 days a week. I mean, I deserve that, right? Yeah. But by not getting an answer, I quickly dispelled the fact that a man could be God. And I always just kept in my heart that I know there is a creator. I couldn't identify with him. I didn't know his name. I didn't know, but I just knew just by my natural inclination that there was one creator. And this is the beauty of why we're here today. And the reminder that I want all of us to reflect on is true happiness comes from knowledge, comes from knowing why you're here. That's the first step to knowing anything. You can read 1,000 books, but if you don't know your purpose of creation, why you're here, then you're still lost. I don't care how many degrees you got, how many bachelors and masters and how many professors you know, you were able to inspire. When it's all said and done, knowing your true purpose of creation, why you're here, why were you created? What is your purpose? To just run around this earth and do whatever it is? And by way of your natural inclination, your natural disposition, you know this isn't true. You know that you have to answer to something greater than yourself. And I'll give you an example. Think of yourself, you know, in a taxi. This driver done told you about his situation. He's very miskin. He's poor. When you get out of the taxi, he accidentally gives you a $100 bill. He meant to give you a 10. But while you're sitting there debating, should I keep it or should I give it back, he already pulls off. A part of you knows that you're going to have to answer for that. Son, right? A part of you knows, if you never see that guy again, to give him his $100 back, a part of you knows that something else saw that. Something else is going to, you know, question me about that. In that short time that I was debating on giving it back or keeping it, I'm going to be held accountable for that. That is your fitra. That is your natural disposition. Something is telling you that you were being seen when you thought you wasn't being seen. So coming to Islam, you know, many things have changed in my life. I know many of y'all know me and seen me on TV and thought I was happy, but I was dying inside. I was dying. I was losing my grip on what I thought was right. I had already fulfilled my initial intention of aiding and helping my loved ones, but now I'm in this lifestyle stuck. I became entertainment for people. And this wasn't happiness. It wasn't happiness. And by understanding what Islam is for, you know, my Muslim brothers and sisters, you cannot give away this happiness. Because the ones that raised their hand, that means that this gift was given to you at birth. You didn't even work for it. You came from the womb of a Muslim. It was given to you. You didn't work for it. You didn't ask for it. You didn't break a sweat.
Ja, ik kwam eigenlijk voornamelijk ook voor de lezing van Remy. Dat is, en de, bij de khutba geeft hij ook, bismillah, mashallah, mooie lezingen. En ja, van broeder Loon, ik had nog niet eerder van hem gehoord. En ik heb pas later van mijn broertje gehoord dat het een rapper was. En ja, helaas kan ik zijn lezing ook niet bijwonen. Ik moet zo mijn dochtertje ophalen. Dus,
Ik en broeder Selim, we zijn van Antwerpen gekomen om broeder Loon en Pierre Vogel. Mogen Allah hen versterken in da'wa.
Amen.
Amen. We komen bezoeken en is onze iman versterken. En wat mij het meeste aantrekt bij Pierre Vogel, allee, meer bij Loon, is... MashaAllah, een paar jaar geleden was ik op zijn muziek aan het dansen in discotheques. En MashaAllah, nu ben ik hier met hem. Hij heeft een baard, ik heb een baard, MashaAllah. Allah Azza wa Jalla heeft ons geleid. Allah Azza wa Jalla zegt, als ik iemand leid, niemand kan me afdwalen. Als ik iemand afdwaal, niemand kan me leiden.
Om even uit te horen hoe het met Loon is. Want we hebben inderdaad gehoord dat hij moslim is geworden. En we wilden eigenlijk wel graag weten wat zijn ervaring is in het dien, zeg maar.
Ik denk dat hij heel veel mensen kan inspireren. Natuurlijk, hij was een voorbeeld voor sommige mensen in de zaal misschien vroeger. Hij zat natuurlijk bij Bad Boy Rappers met P. Diddy en die mensen. En nu... Ja, nu is hij natuurlijk moslim geworden en misschien kan hij diezelfde mensen weer inspireren met het woord van hem.